Hey YouTube, this is 13 Dragon Blade, aka Itachi 13, coming at you with my 6 Samurai deck profile. It has been redone because I told you that I moved the Solemn Brigade, or the Solemn Warning and Judgment, over to my ninja deck as you saw in my updated ninja deck profile. So, let's get this started. I'm going to be going through the monster spells and traps, and then of course extra deck. First we've got two Kaigekis, because Kaigeki is probably the better one to choose of the samurai, as it's just a level 3, and when it's normal summoned, you special a 6 samurai monster, and when there's at least one 6 samurai, he's a 17 beater, so it's 2000 defender, 17 beater, that's all that he's really good for. The one that you need to run 3 of is 3 elder. Elder's good. It's basically the Cyber Dragon. It helps you make rank 3s. It helps you make Shien, just like Kaigeki. And then, of course, we have, because it is important, you have to have 3 Kagemushas. This is always in your deck. You have to run 3. I don't give a crap what anybody tells you. You make sure you run 3, because that's properly how to run samurais. This is basically your tuner for everything that you do when you use Asceticism on, use Asceticism on Elder, and you bring him up, special it immediately from your deck. And the same thing with this guy. Very important. 3 Kizons, because Kizon is good. Kizon lets you get into anything, really. Gets you into your rank 4s, gets you into a sync rank for 6. It's a good card overall. And of course, it becomes a 21 beater when there's 2 samurais with different names on the field, so I believe. Yeah, it just says 2 or more other face-up 6 samurai monsters, so it becomes a 21 beater for each. And I would recommend running him at 3, but I think 2 is just fine, because Kizon is more important than this guy. But Grandmaster's still good. It's a 21 Cyber Dragon that you can just summon. It protects your monsters from being destroyed by card effects, and you can just keep re-abusing him when he's destroyed by like something like Tarantula or something. Then there runs one of only, and run the hand, because hand blows stuff up, and you have to have that extra monster popping when you don't have Shien on board. Same reason behind him, you need to have extra popping, and he's an 18 beater light target, so a lot of people just like running Zanji because, but he's a good card. Same thing with Inishi. Not a lot of people like to run this guy, but he's good. He is a compulse and a monster, and he can become a 22 beater, so that's great. And then the last tech card we have is a Spirit, because Spirit is amazing. You equip it to Legendary 6 Samurai Shien, and every time he kills something by battle, you draw a card, plus it protects himself, so yeah. Then we move on to the spells. We move on to staples. We have a Reborn, we have a Dark Hole, and we have a Heavy Storm, Destruction, and of course Monster Revival. That's all that I really need to discuss here. Then we have Rota, because Rota is amazing, and you have to do this considering that you run Warriors. And of course the Warrior returning alive. A lot of people don't even wonder why I run this. Well, I like to get my samurais back to my hand, and that's one way to do it. As I said before, the other main stuff like the Solemn Brigade was out of here, so I'm strictly sticking with staples. We have 2 Book of Moons, or not, wow, I'm doing well, 2 MSTs for back row hate. If I had 2 Book of Moons, I'd be on crack, man. Anyways, we have 2 MSTs over here because you need to get rid of those back rows. And then 1 Book of Moon, because Book of Moon is good, and it just stops synchro plays, it stops exceed plays, all that good stuff. You have a Cunning, because Cunning is actually quite good. You send a 6 Samurai to the graveyard, and you special a 6 Samurai for me to play this graveyard. Great against a mirror match, and because it gets you any Samurai, any level, it's not a bad card, and it's a quick play. So somebody tries MSTing it, you can just get a Shien back for the sake of doing it. 2 Asceticisms, I know I should run 3, and if I do run 3, I'm probably going to take out the Cunning, or maybe the Warrior returning alive, I don't know yet, but I like this card too, because it sometimes serves me no purpose in late game, because I'll already have Shien on board. 2 Smoke Signals, because you have to grab that Kaigeki, you have to grab that Kagemusha or Elder ASAP. There's no ifs, ands, and buts about it. And then the special cards, Gateway, because Gateway is stupid. And two, Shan's Dojo. Sorry for that glare. Shan's Dojo is good because it just helps you build up counters, then you sacrifice it and you bring out a monster with level less than or equal to the counters you removed. And of course we have Gateway because it's just, if you open with Gateway and you open Dojo, you're gonna win regardless. And then of course the three important draw power cards, because you don't really need duality for this deck. Triple United, because United just gives you that draw power, it helps you build Bushido counters and all that other good stuff. Then the trap lineup, which is very, very simple. Double-edged sword technique, because I have took out the Solemn stuff, again I repeat, and I figured that this would be a great choice. I finally found the other one, so I figured let's just use these, and it's actually worked out a lot better, just bringing back my Samurais. And we still have the two Magatama. If I had three, I would want three, because Magatama just is a complete cop block. It is just such a cop block. It just needs a Samurai to activate it. And then we go to the extra deck. We have one legendary, I think it's Shadow of the Samurai Shin. Decent card, makes your Samurai's 2k beaters. Its effect can be activated during the player's turn, which is really good. And it's just a staple rank 4 that you need. Same reason behind the Utopia. Wow, huge glare there. Same reason behind the Utopia, because Utopia is really good. Then we have Shark Drake, because Shark Drake is another rank 4 that you can use to make with 3 keys on if you're that bored. Same reason behind Shockmaster, because Shockmaster is quite good. And it is a triple rank that can stop monster effects, spells, and traps. This is where I put Chrono Monolith, Crystal Chrono, and I actually switched out Acid Golem for my Agent deck, which I have pimped out a little bit, and you will see in another video. But for right now, we're still going with my revamped Samurais. Crystal Chrono is actually quite good. When he's selected as an attack target, you detach from him once per turn, and you can basically make him unable to be destroyed by battle or card effects, and your opponent will take all the damage that you would take. So, it's a dick move. 1 Giga Brilliant. If Insectors come back, I'm putting this guy in there. Just because he's an insect and because he gives your monsters a good beef up. Livier, because Livier is amazing. If you haven't seen my other videos on how good this card is, then please watch them now. Leviathan Dragon, because he's basically a staple rank 3 at this point, and he's a beater. He's not bad. 1 Shiyan, because if they gave us 2 Shiyans, I would be running 2, and because Shiyan is good. Nothing more need to say about that. Come on, it protects himself and negates the spell and trap. Just the reason behind these two. Negates spells, negates traps. Materia Barkion, it's a ghost gold rare version. I know it's hard to see, but it's there. And Materia Beast, because it negates spells. It helps mill the samurais to the graveyard sometimes. It's a good card. Both of them are good cards. Then the newest addition to the extra deck that I didn't have before was a Colossal Fighter. And you will also see in my other ninja deck profile, I've been taking Utopia Ray in and out of this deck, and it proves to be much better with my ninjas, so I actually just decided to give Colossal Fighter this, because this entire deck is warriors, so very good card. And then, of course, we have Lightning Warrior. When Lightning Warrior is on the field, you just want to inflict that burn damage. Go for it. There's nothing stopping you. Anyways, let's take one last look at him for the video's end. Shadow of the Six Samurai Shien. This is Itachi 13, signing out.